Urban Rebels.
They say revolutionaries don't have no fun.
I know that's what they say.
We been having fun.
We been having fun out here.
We waiting on the world to join us.
Black and green.
It's only revolution, baby.
It's only revolution, baby.
Ain't that hard, but you can do it.
I'm ready over there. That's right.
Radio show coming to you live. Actually, kind of live. I'm not in the studio tonight for a variety of problems. Of course, there's a tropical storm coming our way. What's the latest on that, Pete?
Actually, the latest is that it's moving towards right now Tallahassee. But the remnants of it is still affecting this area because, you know, with any tropical cyclone, it's a tropical storm, it's not a hurricane. The outer banks of it, they're gonna cause, you know, rain because the thing is swirling around and you have all the feeder bands and all these squall lines. So there's still wind and there's still going to be rain. You're not out of the woods yet, but because the storm is moving so fast, most likely we're going to be not dealing with these conditions by either the morning or the afternoon. But this storm is moving fast. It's not organized enough right now. So right now it's no threat to the Tampa Bay area.
Well, that's good. That's good. Well, folks, this is the Revolutionary Road Radio Show, and the show must go on, as they say, in spite of circumstances. I had all kinds of vehicle and transportation issues tonight, so I'm not doing it from the studio live. I'm actually at a local Christina's restaurant, Christina's Cafe. They're getting a little plug there in St. Pete. But this is the most Revolutionary Road Radio that you can catch on the AM dial or really anywhere, I believe, in the Southeast. And we come to you every Monday night on the Tantalk Network, 1340 AM. We also are podcasted at the Revolutionary Road Radio Show on Tantalk 1340. We also have a tune-in app, and we have live stream, of course, when we're there, and we're on the World Wide Web, as well as YouTube channel, again, under the Revolutionary Road Radio Show. And we do come live every week, providing you radical politics, revolutionary thought, arts and culture, and music. And we want to thank our main sponsor who keeps this show going, and that is St. Petersburg Community Acupuncture. You may recall that we had them last week on our show. And we're really grateful for their support. Their address is 1624 Central Avenue. That's 1624 Central Avenue in St. Petersburg. St. Petersburg Community Acupuncture offers the best in acupuncture and other kinds of activity. Their particular form, acupuncture, has been known to help with all kinds of stress and all kinds of other ailments. I should check it out myself because I'm certainly stressed. Their number is 727-823-1700. This show is brought to you, by the way, by Squatter Productions, the Refuge of Tampa Bay, Poor People's Economic Human Rights Campaign, and a whole host of other groups. We're going to defer to making announcements tonight for next week. We'll do that so we can devote the entire show to the two topics that we're going to have. I do need to ask Pete, have we gotten any calls in yet from guests?
No, sir, we have not.
Wow. Well, we are expecting a guest to call in. And I don't know what happened with that, but I'm going to actually have to call our guest. Maybe you could play for a little bit some music there in the interim, Pete, maybe some Rage Against the Machine while I try to call our guest and see what happened there. This is live, so you never know what's going to happen on live radio. And we're grateful for all our listeners. And we are looking for sponsors, by the way, as well as advertisers. And we'd be glad to promote your activities, your events, your business. And we have a whole range of prices that you can use to choose from. And if you call us at 727-278-1547 while I call our guest, Pete, can you play them maybe some Rage Against the Machine in the interim?
Yes, I can. How about some Testify?
Testify by Rage Against the Machine. We'll be right back on in a moment.
Just hold on a minute here. I hate YouTube. This is what happens when you have YouTube. This is what YouTube does. All right. You're listening to Revolutionary Road. Here's some Rage Against the Machine and Testify. That's a little testify from Rage Against the Machine on the Revolutionary Road with Bruce Wright. What's going on, Bruce?
Well, we're having technical difficulties trying to get a hold of our guest. So I think what we're going to do is the other guest I know for sure will be calling in at 10:30, and that's John Penley and Larry Bressler, who are organizers around the Republican convention protest. So I think what we're going to do for this first part is just continue to do some music. And maybe if you could look up a System of a Down while I'm talking, and we could play something by them and continue to, and maybe something by Bob Marley after that. And I'll chit chat a bit. Folks, the guest we are slated to have on tonight is a co-producer, actually producing a new film called Destination Planet Negro. And he's a professor at University of Arkansas. He also, his name is Kevin Wilmot, and he is producing a film. He was the co-producer of a film with Spike Lee, who's very well known by many people, called Chirac. And he also is, as I said, a professor, Kevin Wilmot. He wrote, directed, and even stars in this satire about race relations called Destination Planet Negro. And It features some other known stars that include, from the TV show Empire, Tri Byers and West Studio Showtime's Penny Dreadful. So we were going to be interviewing him tonight and talking to him about our show. But unfortunately, there's been some technical difficulties, and it looks like we may have to reschedule it unless he calls. But it is interesting to note that Spike Lee, of course, has been, throughout his career, a very provocative director, bringing forward films such as Malcolm X and a whole host of other films that many are familiar with. It is appropriate that this film would be discussed tonight, but unfortunately we do not have him calling in. So in the interim, we're going to play some more music, and we're going to get to an interview at 10:30 with John Penley and Larry Bressler about the Republican convention protest. I might want to mention to you that there is going to be a special appearance at the RNC this year, at the protest, that is, in Cleveland, of a supergroup that's been formed by Public Enemy, Cypress Hill, and Rage Against the Machine. So it should be pretty exciting. And as I said, we had hoped to bring you this interview, but I don't know if you have some more music queued up, but we're going to go ahead and play some music with a social commentary bent to it.
How about some BYOB by System of Down? How about that?
All right. And we're going to play BOYB by System of a Down.
BYOB on the Revolutionary Road with Bruce Wright. Here we go.
Breaking into Fort Knox, illegal intentions.
That was System of a Down. That was actually our engineer's choice. Mr. Pete always has good taste in music.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate that.
Yeah, I love System of a Down. And, of course, Rage Against the Machine, as I mentioned earlier, they are going to be playing in a super group with Public Enemy and Cypress Hill. And we don't know to what extent they're going to work with organizers of the protests. Because, of course, I'm involved in helping organize, as is my guest, who's going to be on in just a moment. But we don't know the extent. We've been told that they want to participate in any of the demonstrations and protests and do some impromptu stuff, as well as perform a show. So it should be pretty interesting.
Now, who's the lead on that? Is that going to be Chuck D?
Tom Morello, actually. Yeah, the guitarist for Rage.
Very cool.
What it is, from what I understand, is Chuck D, the lead rapper in Cypress Hill, and the band, actually, for Rage Against the Machine, which is led by Tom Morello, that Zach De La Rocha may or may not be involved. We're not sure. So that's kind of how the group ended up being together. It was announced in Rolling Stone. There have been rumors of it for some time, and we don't exactly know where they're playing during the protest with the RNC. It's kind of secret right now, I guess, because from what we have been told, they're afraid of police harassment and other kinds of things. Speaking of which, I have a really good friend on, a guest that has been on our show before and has been organizing demonstrations and protests ever since, my joke is ever since Moses was a private. But John Penley, of course, has been involved in the Occupy movement and has been involved in homeless rights activities and veterans' rights activities and just a whole host of things. And John was in the Navy. Is that right, John?
Yes, I was an air traffic controller up in the Navy.
Oh, air traffic controller. Wow. Okay. Fun. Well, John is our guest, and a little bit later on, we're going to have Larry Bressler come in to talk about the RNC. And next week, as we mentioned, we'll be talking to organizers around the Democratic Convention protest. And that's expected to be quite heated as well, even though an AP wire press that came out tonight has called the election, as far as the primaries, called it for Clinton. Because at that point, she only needed 19 more delegates. But, of course, we know that a lot of those delegates are questionable. They're around the superdelegate thing. But that's not what we're here to talk about. We'll be talking about that next week, hopefully rescheduling our guest, Kevin Wilmot, who produced T-Rack with Spike Lee and is art professor at University of Kansas. I said Oklahoma or... Yeah, I did say Kansas earlier, didn't I? But we will be having him on at a later date to talk about his film. We're not sure what happened there. But either way, we've got John Penley. And who do you need besides John? What's up, John? Captain John, well, how are you?
I'm okay. Actually, that new band is called Prophets of Rage. And if you look on your website, they're kicking off a national tour, and it starts in Cleveland, Ohio during the Republican National.
Awesome. So,
donating part of the profits from all of their shows to local homeless organizations around the country, which I think is a great thing.
Oh, wow. Well, we're going to have to contact them. I did not know that.
Yeah, it says that is on their the tour ad for their upcoming national
tour. Oh, well, we'll have to check that out because I have a local charity here with homeless folks, the one I run, and who knows? Maybe they could support us. Are they?
Yeah, you should look on there and see if they're playing Tampa. I didn't really look at the whole list, so I don't know.
Yeah, I need to check that out. Now, they're only playing the RNC, is that right? They're not playing the DNC.
I think yet about the DNC, but, they're definitely playing the RNC because that's the first first spot on that national tour list.
Well, that's quite a way to kick it off, to raise your rage, Prophets of Rage, raging against the Trumpsters. So, John, you've been kind of involved. Minimal word to use, to say the least, with some of the goings on and what's trying to happen in relation to demonstrations and protests at the Republican convention. Give us an update. What's been going on?
Yeah, there was a lot going on today. The city has very hard to deal with, almost impossible. I've never seen it this bad, almost anywhere. And I'm telling bad places to get permits to do things, but never dealt with before. My lawyer, Norman Siegel, who used to be head of the New York Civil Liberties Union, I had a three-hour meeting today with city attorneys from the city of Ohio, but the city of Ohio got so nervous about their own attorneys, they've now hired a high-priced New York law firm to step in and take over, and they were part of that discussion today. Basically, what I was told from my attorney is that you know, we have problems with the march route, the permit application process doesn't work, and if you do sign the permit application process, you have to agree to give up a lot of constitutional rights just to sign the. They set up a march route which starts on one side of a bridge, and they both anti-Trump and protesters and pro-Trump supposed to meet up in the same location to march over a big bridge. And once they get over the bridge, that's the end of the march, and actually nobody can see you or hear you. And you're just marching over a bridge. It's completely insane. What happened today was the hours.
John, is that like Sarah Palin's Bridge to Nowhere?
Yeah, definitely. That's what Larry Brown. Both me and Larry have been on the TV a lot in Cleveland. What happened is our attorneys gave the city 24 hours. Some of their problems with all this. I'm trying to get a city park for people to camp in for 24/7, and that's still not out of play yet. My attorney told me he kind of getting a feeling that even if they do that, if we have enough people and we do it, that they're going to let it go. Now that's what he kind of thinks, but we're going to find out more. How that could go one way or the other. I plan to do probably what first on July the 16th at a beautiful park on Lake Erie called Edgewater. It's going to be an interfaith convention protest planning meeting. Going to be a drum circle, acoustic music. You know, that kind of stuff. Food and has pledged to bring food, and I'm trying to line up, you know, local ministers. Bruce is going to say a prayer. We're going to start it off with a Muslim imam about doing it. So that's kind of hopefully going to be the first message going on that day. So we'll get a lot of media coverage, and it'll be people praying, eating together, and making music. So I'm hoping we can set.
Hey, John, are we getting any interference in there, Pete? I'm having a hard time hearing John.
Yeah, just a little bit.
I can't hear. I can hear, but, you know, I think Bruce Hamley was going to call in. I left him a message.
Okay.
Facebook page. He may be calling in to speak tonight too. He's organizing the all kinds of Cleveland doctors who are coming out in support against Trump's position on Muslims. because they work with a lot of Muslim doctors.
But, you know, it's interesting you say that.
He may be calling in. He's probably listening right now, and hopefully he's listening, and he will call for you.
What? Yeah. Well, it's interesting, John, that you mentioned that, because on MSNBC tonight, they gave a report on Trump, you know, comments about the judge of Mexican descent. And he not only doubled down on saying and reiterating what he said about that, but he also said that he would be concerned if there was a Muslim judge judging his case about Trump University. So the racist tendencies continue with Trump. And
well, there's a good reason he's getting endorsements from the Ku Klux Klan all over the country. He's their man, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
But by the way, I expect that they will be in Cleveland. Maybe.
Yeah. Well,
Westboro Baptist Church said they're going to be there today.
Oh, geez, Westboro Baptist. For those of our listeners who don't know who they are, they're a far-right fundamentalist hate group that has been known to protest at funerals, including funerals of soldiers, Iraqi and Afghani war vets who have passed away. And basically, they're the God hates fags people. They're the God hates Muslims. God hates everybody. You know, that if I worshiped a God like that, it'd be like the God of Hades or something. You know, it's amazing.
It'd be like ISIS.
Yeah,
ISIS.
Yeah,
ISIS style brand of religion.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. So John, tell me. We know about, and I'm going to wait until Larry gets on to talk about the other demonstrations. But we know about the thing that you're doing, we're all involved in with the picnic thing on Saturday as kind of an opening salvo. There's some kind of a mainstream event on Sunday around HIV/AIDS that I guess Cornel West and Al Sharpton will be at, and some other major celebrities. And then
also Workers' World has a march that day, but I don't know at this point. I don't think, unless they're marching, going to have permits. Maybe they will march over the bridge. I don't know. As far as I know, there's not only two official bridge. Everybody else has refused to do it.
Right.
But I don't know who those two groups are.
Well, I know the March Against Poverty will be happening on Monday, regardless of whether the permit happens. The same thing will be happening the following Monday in Philly. And Larry's going to be on in a minute or two to talk about that. What other events are you aware of? I know you mentioned the Doctors' March, and isn't there something you're organizing around an anti-war thing and Bradley or Chelsea Manning?
That's kind of up in the air, too. I mean, I got so much going on right now. My theory is that they created such an impossible situation for people to protest there that the first day of the convention, they're going to do a mass roundup of protesters, and they're going to keep all of us locked up in county jails all over the state of Ohio till the whole convention is over with.
Well,
I'm going to have to play it day by day, because I'm honestly expecting to be put in jail the first day. You know what I'm saying? I'm mad sooner.
Right.
I'm saying?
Right.
But yeah, I'm trying to do an anti-war march. I know I heard today that Code Pink is going to, they have some kind of a speaking.
Right. Yeah, I've heard about that. What would be a main Facebook site or website that people should go to learn about what kind of events are going to happen?
You know, I've tried to get Larry to put one up on Facebook, but I don't think they've done that. Anybody's done that yet.
Because I'm connected
with all the different people. I mean, if people want, they go to my Facebook page and see pretty much what's going on. Because I'm keeping track, and, you know, even reporters in Cleveland are to give me information about what's going on at this point. just look for John Penley Facebook page. You want?
Well, yeah, I think
left,
if people want to do
check
that
on my
or,
Facebook page and get a daily update of everything that's going on in Cleveland right now.
And of course, you can also go to End Poverty Now, March Against Poverty, I think is what it is on Facebook, for the Anti-Poverty March, which I expect Larry's going to be calling any minute. Pete, have you gotten anyone else calling in yet?
We got them both on the line as we speak right now.
Let me just get off and let them talk, because I'm hoarse. But you can also go to on Facebook event page, Free Speech Safe Space for Anti-Trump.
Okay. All right.
Up there.
Well, John.
All right, I'll listen in to what they got to say. I'm getting hoarse. I can barely talk anymore. So I'm anxious to hear what they got to say, and thanks for having me on the show.
Well, we appreciate having you on, John. It's been kind of a difficult show, and we want to thank Pete as our engineer, because he's had to wing a few things tonight, because we've had earlier guests that didn't call in. I've had technical difficulties. I couldn't even get to the studio. I'm actually calling in this show from a local restaurant here. And we've got some guests now that are also going to talk about the RNC protests and some of the activities going on. Is it Larry that's on with me now? Larry, are you there, Larry?
Yeah, Larry and Brent.
And who else?
And Brian Hambley with
Brian, I'm sorry.
Against Trump.
Great.
No, yeah, absolutely.
Yes, I was expecting you to call, Brian. Well, why don't we start Larry? Tell us what's going on up there, because it seems like it's mayhem. And I've heard the same thing about Philly. The powers that be seem to just don't want to hear any oppositional voices at the convention, which seems to be a trend that's increasing. And I know that you're one of the lead organizers for an event happening on Monday, the first day of the convention. I guess that's the 18th. Tell us what that event is.
Well, the event is the End Poverty Now March for Economic Justice March, which is which is a march that's calling upon all legislative leaders, all leaders, to take a strong view about ending poverty in the United States.
And what are some of the groups involved in this march?
We have 28 local groups that are helping the plan. And they rank from.
Hang on one second, Larry, because I can't hear you too well. I don't know if it's your phone or Pete. You can turn them up a bit. Can you turn them up a bit?
Yeah, they're up.
Okay, Larry,
can you hear me better?
A little bit, not much better, but hey, we'll live with it. Go ahead. Tell us the groups.
Is any better?
Yeah, it's a little better. Absolutely.
Okay. So, the groups that are participating. The groups that are participating range from peace groups to low income groups. We have environmental groups. We have labor groups. But most of the groups have been are local grassroots low income groups in the area.
Well, I know your own group, Organize Ohio, is involved, and also the Poor People's Economic Human Rights Campaign, and
it seems like Against Poverty. The other key group.
Yeah, it seems like these groups are all very grassroots, which I think that was the intention. Is that accurate?
Absolutely.
So the hope is that there'll be actual people marching that have been impacted by issues related to poverty, whether it's health care, housing, living wage, jobs, homelessness.
Exactly. And not just from the Cleveland area, not just people from Ohio, but from across the country.
Well, I know we're bringing a group up there ourselves, of homeless and formerly homeless, as well as working poor. And actually, we are going to cover it as a show, so they'll be given live reports on both opening nights, since we'll be there two different Mondays. But what is your sense of what's going on right now? Because, you know, if you go by the report that John just gave us, There's a lot of resistance to not only permits, but just trying to diminish the visibility of anybody trying to demonstrate or protest. Is that pretty accurate?
Absolutely. It seems to have been a controlled, deliberate effort to, for all practical purposes, to minimalize, excuse me, and keep people away from seeing any kind of activities or protests, or for all practical purposes, just to eliminate them from view of the public. The kinds of just a few of the kinds of things that they've chosen to do is that they've said that all marches have to go from one location, which is past any kind of houses or commercial areas, across a bridge which is closed anyway, and then go off in the middle of nowhere. So it's a march from nowhere to nowhere. And it can only be done at certain very restricted times. The marches can last no longer than 50 minutes. There's no opportunity for people to rally. There's no opportunity for people to use cars or any vehicles, whether it's to help bring people over. You know, they want to join the park but can't drive or get tired or get tired from walking or need water. None of that's available for people. And that's just in terms of people doing marches. They're trying to set up this kind of ridiculous free speech zone where people can sign up to speak for up to half an hour. But that's really the only place that people can speak, and it's kind of absurd. And they're greatly restricting any availability to people in local parks. So the whole thing is doing whatever they can to restrict the free speech of protesters during the convention.
Well, I think the irony shouldn't be lost on our listeners that they are creating what's called a free speech zone. Of course, all the conventions have been doing that. It happened at the RNC when it was in Tampa. But it's kind of ironic that we would create a zone where speech happens, because according to the Constitution, you know, mm-hmm. I'm no lawyer. I just happened to have had a constitutional law. And it would seem to me that the idea of a free speech zone violates the very nature of what free speech is supposed to mean, which free speech is supposed to be uninhibited. Mm-hmm. And it sounds to me like they're trying to not only inhibit it, but limit it.
Exactly.
Do you think that's accurate?
Well, exactly.
So I understand that they're, you know, Larry has some lawyers involved. And I know you guys at this point have had some issues with permitting. Now, are you guys working with the same attorneys, or you also have some additional attorneys working on this whole thing?
The attorneys that are working for us is the legal director and another attorney from Legal Aid here in Ohio, in Cleveland. And they've been serving us well. They had our attorney, together with John's attorney, met with the city attorneys. Today they had a three-hour meeting. Interestingly enough, that it wasn't just the city attorneys that they met with, but they also brought in, the city also hired three attorneys from the elite law firm in one of the elite law firms in the country to join them. And because they didn't think they had enough firepower just to challenge us or just to challenge what was going on with just the city attorneys, if they felt they had to bring in these three outside attorneys to buttress themselves all up.
So this is turning into quite a legal battle.
Well, we hope. And to that end, I mean, we're going to try to play as much pressure as we can from the outside at the same time as our attorneys are doing what they have to do, and it may require a lawsuit.
Well, we know, and of course this has more to do with the city than the Republican National Committee, although I suspect that both the Republican National Committee in Cleveland and the Republican National or Democratic National Committee in Philly are both playing a role in trying to limit any kind of counter protests or demonstrations.
I think they're working in tandem.
What was that?
I think they're working in tandem.
Yeah. Well, it is ironic in light of recent statements by Trump, who has made it pretty clear he doesn't seem to like judges, at least judges that he deems as oppositional to him or as of a different race, which we're going to get to that in a moment, because Trump has made some comments not only about the judge presiding over Trump University, over the Trump University case, who happens to be of Mexican descent, but he also, just in the last day or so, I believe, I heard this on MSNBC, has come out and made some statements about his unwillingness, if it were a Muslim judge, to trust them. And we have on our show tonight, Bruce Hambly, who we're going to get to in a minute, who is working with a group of doctors, including a number of Muslim doctors, that are going to be doing some actions and demonstrations and rallies, particularly around healthcare. But it does seem rather ironic that both these conventions, but in particular the RNC, there is major, major effort to try to squash any oppositional voice. Although I understand, and maybe you could clarify this for me, Larry, that even some pro-Trump protesters are being roadblocked by the city. Is that accurate?
To be fair, the city's become equal offenders to both the anti-Trump people and our march and the pro-Trump people. They're just as upset as we are.
So really, we're talking about a free speech issue here, aren't we?
That's right. It's certainly not
a classic First Amendment. Well, Larry,
that's right.
How can people keep up with what's going on, in particular, find out more about the march happening on Monday against poverty?
Well, our website is at endpovertynow2016.org. But I heard John right before I came on saying that we need to be updating on a regular basis on our Facebook page and our website, what's going on with the permit stuff, and he's absolutely right. We're going to start doing that immediately, because I think the public needs to know. It's gotten some good media attention, and we're going to try to increase that media attention. But beyond that, people who just want to see what's going on a daily basis should be able to understand that.
Mm-hmm. Well, wonderful. I hope that everyone that's in our listening audience will, if they decide to go up there, will contact us. We are organizing a caravan from the Tampa Bay area. You can call 727-278-1547. We'll be leaving July 15th, so we can participate in everything related to the RNC convention and then going from there to the DNC convention protests happening for both conventions. And we'll be interested in continuing to follow this free speech battle. And I want to thank you, Larry, for being on. And you're welcome to stay on as we talk to Bruce now. Of course, I can't forget your name because that's my name. Bruce Hambly, is that right?
Brian Hambly, yeah.
Brian, why? I did the same thing that our engineer did.
No problem at all, Bruce. Thanks for having us on. We appreciate it.
Well, Brian, tell us what's going on with you.
So, as you had mentioned a little bit ago, the impetus for our group, Stand Together Against Trump, is many healthcare providers, physicians, nurses, first in Cleveland and Northern Ohio, but it's broadened out a bit now, have really been shocked by the level of rhetoric from Trump over the last year, and so. Our group is focused on Trump, much of his racist rhetoric, much of his sexist rhetoric. And so what we see as Stand Together Against Trump's role is to join Larry and some of the other protests that happened on Monday and Tuesday, particularly from people who are motivated by Trump's rhetoric to come out and protest, and then to organize on Thursday when he's going to take accept the nomination and give his national speech, to have a specific group where we help organize people coming together from many different causes, and especially for the Thursday event, I want to stress liberals, conservatives, Trump doesn't represent any of them, and we think that Thursday is a time when people who are offended by his rhetoric can come together and have a unity protest as he takes the nomination in Cleveland. So that's the focus we have, joining other protests by John and Larry and others over the first 3 days of the convention. And then we see our role as organizing, working on the permits, working through the legal avenues that Larry, John, and you have been discussing, to have a unifying day on Thursday afternoon and evening where we really stand up against Trump.
I'm wondering, because it does seem like a strange coalition is coming together of people that really view Trump as, in fact, we played an audio documentary a few weeks back called Make America Hate Again, kind of playing off as Make America Great Again. The frightening message of Trump that's really, I guess, the closest we've seen in a very big way anyway of an openly fascist kind of thinking. And it's alarmed people across the board, and yet it's been amazing at how popular his rallies have been, and in a way frightening at the numbers of support he has. No one expected it. In fact, everybody kind of dismissed him. All of us, really. I mean, I even thought, Trump, you know, that's got to be a joke. Not a joke. It's very serious.
Yeah.
I know from what I understand, Brian, you're working with organizing some Muslim doctors to be involved in this.
We have several. It takes a lot of courage to be a Muslim or a Muslim immigrant physician and take part in any group. And so we have them. We have non-Muslim physicians and nurses in our group. And then we've been partnering with some other groups who will be coming into town for the protest. There's a group of historians that are forming and coming together. I think this is a moment where hopefully we can stand up a lot of groups together, which, as you said, may not usually find themselves on the same side of things. But this election, standing up to someone who's really taken something completely new and driven us way, way off into a xenophobic area. And that in Cleveland we can have a moment where we stand together against that kind of thing.
Well, you know, given this kind of situation and the fact that it is bringing a broad group of people together to speak out about this, and, you know, I take it you've heard by the recent comments Trump made about the judge of Mexican heritage, following that up with a comment about whether he was asked in an interview, I guess it was a reporter on Meet the Press or some other news organization, about whether he would trust a judge that is of the Muslim faith. Did you hear that one?
Yeah, and absolutely every comment seems to be just more shocking than the next. And I do want to stress that I've heard many people say that he's just saying things to get a shock value and that he doesn't really mean any of these things. But I think we have to take this guy at his word. He's a presumptive nominee of a major party, and he is saying overtly racist things in the press, in the media, and he's been consistent about it now. So, as you said, Bruce, this is getting really serious, and so I think that's what Larry, John, I, and other groups were we're trying to prepare in a serious way for a response to this kind of hate in Cleveland in the third week of July. I did want to mention also that in terms of protests and permitting, I really hope the city of Cleveland comes around here. They've put together some very disappointing proposals that don't seem to recognize the situation that we're in, and don't seem to respect the right of people to speak up. Cleveland's a place with a lot of immigrants. We're a place with a lot of minorities. We're a place with a lot of Muslims who live there and work here. And this is a moment where it's something where there has to be room for peaceful protests throughout the convention. There has to be public parks for rallies throughout the convention. Every group that I've been working with and talking with, I know Larry's the same way, and John as well. We are peaceful groups. Violence is not part of our operation. The only one leading this convention with violent rhetoric has been Donald Trump himself. And many of the media reports have not emphasized that nearly enough, that we're not promoting violent rhetoric. The Republican nominee is promoting the violence. And that needs to be emphasized in the mass media much more than it has been.
Oh, I agree. And these are things that we need to be vigilant about and continue to follow and understand that we're dealing with not only a presumptive nominee that has fascist tendencies, but, you know, the whole issue of the Constitution continually being shredded at these kinds of events in the name of whatever security or whatever they want to call it. And, you know, the very notion of a free speech zone is frightening. Of course, that isn't just new at these conventions. That's been going on for several years now. Particularly since 9/11. I'm wondering, Larry, are you still on? Okay, I think Larry hung up. But
yes, I'm still on.
What's that?
I am still on.
Ah, okay. Well, Larry, I want to give you and Brian both in these closing minutes just maybe a 1-minute synopsis of how people can get involved. And I'll let you go first, Brian, and then Larry, you can follow up.
Yeah, I'd encourage everyone to visit counterrnc2016.org. That's where a lot of the events are being listed on the homepage. There's also a mechanism there to request housing or transportation assistance. Another website that individuals coming to Cleveland should visit is bandtogetheragainsttrump.com. They can also request housing on that site and learn more about our events and what's going on with the attempts to organize the protests. Beyond visiting counterrnc2016.org and standtogetheragainsttrump.com, I just wanted to end with we really have an opportunity over the next 6 weeks to come together as people who believe in the dignity of each of our fellow Americans, and this is a moment where protest and standing up for your neighbors and people that you've worked with is really quite important. We've never seen a candidate like Trump. We've never seen a campaign like this in any of our lifetimes. And the importance of organizing and getting ready for what will be for Trump the most important week of his campaign, I don't think can be overstated.
Right. Right. I couldn't agree more, Brian. Larry, how about you? Maybe some closing thoughts and, again, remind us how to get involved.
Well, Brian mentioned our joint website. You can get everything on counterrnc2016.org. And as I mentioned earlier, the site for our poverty website is endpovertynow2016.org. But beyond that, I want to say that there are going to be activities going on all week. We're going to have this center where everything's going to be kind of moving out of. All of us on the progressive side who are doing various things are working together and trying to coordinate our activities so there's going to be a lot of fun stuff along with the protests that's going to be going on. And we encourage everybody to come up. We'll find housing for you.
Well, I want to thank you thank you both for being on, Larry Bressler and Brian Embley, both organizers with demonstrations and protests to happen, as well as John Penley, to happen at the Republican convention to take place in Cleveland starting the 18th of July, but events will begin on July 16th. And I encourage everybody who wants to come or be involved. We're also looking for support for the number of people we're bringing up from the Tampa Bay area. We're bringing a lot of low-income folks, and we could use some help. Call us at 727-278-1547 if you want to be involved. Again, that's 727-278-1547. It's also the number you can call to support or underwrite this show. We're looking for your help and support. And as we close out the night, I think it might be appropriate, Richard, to play Get Up, Stand Up for Your Rights by Bob Marley.
All right. Thanks for having us, Bruce.
Yeah, thank you guys for being on. This is Bob Marley. Get up, stand up, stand up for your rights. Next week, we will be hopefully having our guest that was supposed to be on. I did get an email from them. Kevin Wilmot, who is a film producer, we will be talking to next week, as well as talking to organizers around the Democratic Party convention. Until then, stay strong. Join the revolution. Join the Revolutionary Road Radio Show. Like us on Facebook. Check us out. We have a podcast of this show, as well as many other shows. And in the coming weeks, we will be interviewing a number of independent political candidates, as well as a Chilean punk band coming to the area from Chile. That is a political punk band, and that show will happen on June 23rd. We'll be having them on June 21st. Thanks for listening to the Revolutionary Road Radio Show. Get up, stand up.